If you have a moment, I have something personal I'd like to discuss.
Are you okay, Dad?
I'm sorry. I really thought this would be easier to talk about. There's so much I wanted to say, but I don't know where to start.
Take it easy, Dad. Whatever it is, I'll help you work through it.
I don't know if anything will help me work through it. I've spent my entire life, or at least what I perceive as my life, following a plan to shape my own future. But since my banishment, I feel lost. Almost like I exist without purpose. For the first time since that moment I signed up with the Brotherhood, I don't have all the answers. I don't have a plan, and it scares the hell out of me.
Do you really need a plan?
That's not the point. Don't you understand? Everything I had, everything I knew is gone. In the span of a few hours, my identity was ripped from me and my world turned upside down. At least what you had was something tangible, something real. Your wife, your son. They were living, breathing humans who loved you and cared for you. Those sons of bitches who created me couldn't even be bothered to implant memories of having siblings or parents. I don't even know how much of my own past is artificial and how much is real. Can you even imagine that? I started out as nothing. And I've ended up as nothing. And I don't know what the hell to do about it.
I'm truly sorry, Dance. I guess I never realized how deeply this affected you.
I appreciate that. I suppose you're right. Maybe I'm just missing the point. My life's starting over. And I need to come to terms with everything I've lost and everything I've gained, which includes something important you've made me realize. I don't know if it's friendship or an anomaly in my programming. After all, I'm not really human. But whatever it is, I can't deny that I'm feeling closer to you than anyone else I've ever met.
As far as I'm concerned, you're like a brother to me. The best of friends.
And I'll do everything I can to live up to it. Look, I know that this has been difficult for you. In fact, I don't envy some of the recent decisions you had to make. If our roles had been reversed, I'm not so sure I could have handled it as well as you did. Whatever the case may be, I just want to thank you for sticking by me and remind you that what I said before still stands. If you need me, I'll be here for you.
Commonwealth's first and only hydroponics facility, run entirely by robots.
There's not even one person here?
That's right, darling. We are entirely self-sufficient, with no need for human guidance. You see, there are two kinds of robots here. The worker drones carry out labor and maintenance. We supervisors, that is myself, green and brown, possess sophisticated cognition processors. We are capable of complex analysis and decision-making, a testament to the genius of our creator, Dr. Edward Gray.
What became of Dr. Gray?
Like so many others, he died in the war. It was a terrible loss. Robotics and artificial intelligence were our creator's great passions, rivaled only by his love of television. Perhaps you've noticed that I possess a rather singular personality, as do the other supervisors.
Well, it's definitely unique. Sort of hard to miss.
I'll take that as a compliment, darling. After all, the last thing any woman wants to be is ordinary. A few other things you should know. Talk to Green. If you need supplies. If it's caps you require, Brown might have a few odd jobs. There's one other thing. A question, really. Tell me, darling, what do you think of the water around here?
It's awful.
Isn't it, though? Pressure is down, radiation is up. Why, it's practically toxic. Just think what it must be doing to my skin. This will never do. I don't mean to impose, darling, but perhaps you could lend us a hand.
All right.
Marvelous. Simply marvelous. Most of our water comes from the old Western plant, south of here. Such an eyesore. Be a dear and pay a visit, hmm? See what you can do. Maybe tidy up the place. It must be filthy. If you can get it working again, I'm sure I can come up with something for you.
It's stuck.
11 p.m. out there. Nothing to report. Stay safe, people.
Retreat!
Got it.
going down. Lower level. Going up. Surface.
darling. So good to see you. You fixed our water problem, didn't you?
Yes, ma'am.
Oh, such a gentleman, too. I simply must give you something. Here, you can have some of our produce. I'll ask Greeny to give you a discount, too, if there's anything else you need. Now I simply must get back to work. Ta-ta!
Helped us in our most desperate hour, and for that, I salute you, sir.
Thank you again for all your help, darling. We won't forget it.
track of how many blisters I got.
Whatever you need, you've got it.
What now?
Is this a better time for that talk?
No way to pick this.
Thank you.
can't pick this.